get out of the way, Matt.
Woo!
It's time to make it run. Been doing all kinds of silly little off-the-camera stuff that you never get to see because it's just tiny little things that need to be done. Glued and painted and grinded and blah, blah, blah. You've got like 150 aftermarket parts all trying to work together. They don't, but we make them. We massage them. It's fine. It's good. It's going to start. This is it. This is the video. I guarantee it's going to start. I mean, we did this last time, remember? That's the correct noise. Pick up right where we were last time. Let's get the headlight on. Or it's funny with this thing. It was heavy enough and awkward enough. I had to like really stop and plug it in, but now I just kind of plug it in.
Pump, whatever it is, the power.
And I think that's the meter as well.
It just helps to have that third hand.
Look, R32, every day. R32 drives by. You missed it, guys. Oh, it's all blurred. I'm going to fill it with just distilled water for now. I'm gonna run this through it. Same with the oil. I'm basically gonna run this bike up with the oil it's got in it right now. And once it's got some heat in it, I'll just flush all these fluids out because there's no way I don't have little bits of lint and crap, you know, from like the cloths, the shop towels I was using. I'll have to fill the rest of the way up as I start it. There's gonna be a lot of things to do on this first start. I got some fresh premium because it has been like, I guess a couple months since I started this. So just dump the old stuff in the truck. Truck won't care. This bike probably wouldn't care anyway, but let's get some clean stuff for here. You got that? Yeah. Thank you, buddy. I'm not gonna fill it up or anything. I'm just gonna throw a little bit of this in. Oh my God, that's not on all the way at all. Well, luckily that spilt on the floor. All right, take two. So this is gonna be the first start here, the first attempt to start. Like I said, there's a bunch of things we gotta check while it's running, so Matt's gonna keep topping off that water. I gotta be checking like for weird engine sounds, leaks of any kind around the base gasket, head gasket, the exhaust everywhere. So there's a lot to do. We also have not changed the tuning at all on the, right now it's on the old tuning, which will probably be a bit lean, but it should be fine for just kind of running it up right here. All right, you ready to go?
Yep.
All right, let's get that off. We should get, let's make sure we're getting all our good gauges here. Yep, we are showing fuel. Pump went. I want you to do this. We'll stop. Hit it again. All right, let's see. I bet you it's gonna fire right up. Here, we'll do a cycle again. Going here, good lord.
Hey, it's moving there.
Yeah,
look at all that smoke
over there. That's actually probably mostly what that is the packing material in there, smoking.
Yeah.
I'm surprised the cylinder hasn't started smoking yet because that's got a neighbors.
It's fine. I'll just bend down like a loser. Hear my knees popping?
Don't even talk to me about that.
Oh, I will talk to you about that, sir.
I turned 30 this year. I have to buy a Corvette.
Oh, I can buy 30 this year. I'm going to turn 40 in a few more years. Turn 38 in a few days.
I'm going to say Jake instead of Matt.
All right, now I'm looking at this because there's already some oil in here. I'm trying to see if it looks sparkly. I know it's only running for a minute. The only sparkle I see is on the frame, which looks good.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm looking at the frame too. I'm looking at the oil.
Yeah, it looks fine. Oh, how are you doing? I've been thinking of this as like an oil change. It's more like just a little flush out. Just topped off the coolant with actual coolant. That. And now I'm gonna throw a little bit in here. Some of you guys like to give me a hard time for that. You don't need to put any in here. That's just the overflow. I know it is, but think about this. 5-6 ounces trickles out, it gets hot, goes into here. When it goes to siphon that back up, when it cools,
if you only have the exact amount it needs, it's definitely going to pull a bunch of air too. So we want to have a little bit in there, or I'm not fill up to the low line, actually maybe a little above it, honestly, then you don't risk that problem. It now has a little bit of a pocket of water on there. Does that make sense? Savvy? Okay. Remember, Jake went to school. I'm going to put this cover on now. Just got to look and see which hole, which bolts it needs removed. These are the bolts I went and picked up at the store, just some stainless ones. They add the exact same bolt, just better quality. It does look though like with this cover, much like the other one, maybe even more so, is that it's not 100% the right shape. They're going to be one of those operations where you want to get all of them in and then kind of stage them down. I have to imagine that once this thing's been through a number of heat cycles, it'll probably be the correct shape. Yeah. Kind of train it a little bit. All right. Hardware it came in was pretty junky, but I got some good stuff on there now. Bolted this on, bolted that on, they do work. You have to trim a little bit of plastic in here, but they do fit together. Everything's looking all blacked out now. Probably ought to get some brakes going. I always get you a new bottle of this stuff. Anyone who's seen me do this a number of times knows I love this tool right here. If you have a compressor, I only have a 17 gallon, so I'm not that big. But if you have a compressor, a tool like this is about 70 bucks. I think it's a great investment. Just a vacuum bleeder. We're gonna hook this up on here, push this down, and it's gonna draw all the fluid through. In fact, it'll draw it so quick, we really need to keep an eye on it up here that we don't pull it all the way down and then get a bubble in the system, because then you basically have to start over. Really nice, especially when the lines are completely full of air. Like when you're bleeding out old lines, it's a little easier because you've got, you know, something in the system, but when it's completely full of air like it is now, it's really hard to just pump it and get it to go out. You can do it, it's just such a pain. Yep, there we go. Now it's good. It's good. Let's go to the front. It's definitely all bled down there. There's just a few little bubbles. I mean, it's... Oh, yeah, careful, those little pops. You pull it in and you let it go quickly. That's what gives that little pop there. And that's there, we've got it. Sorry, lawnmower noises in the background. I just wanted to show you guys real quick. We can't see it, but I probably only used like this much of this bottle anyway. It's like, that's where that tool's great. It just actually, it's efficient. You don't waste. Like, I remember doing the whole pumping thing. You'd be doing that forever. And you'd use like almost a whole one of these to do a dirt bike. The other method, very quick, very good. There's one final thing I want to do, which has to do with the tune on the bike. The tune is obviously off right now. That tune was done by Dynojet, and it was for the opened up airbox, CBR cams, emissions delete, full exhaust. And now we're running, well, I've got a CBR boot on the end, which I don't have tuning for, full Yosh, which is looks to be a lot more high flow, and of course a big bore ported head and even more aggressive cams. Ari Henning, the guy who sold me the big bore kit, has done basically the exact same thing I've done to a Rally, minus the ported head and cams. So he sent me over his map of the Power Vision 3. This is a tuner, by the way. We got this from Dynojet. This directly flashes the ECU. You have a crazy amount of control with that. So I took his map, made a copy of it, and just threw like 5% more fuel at it to hopefully kind of get me within the ballpark. Might be too much in places, probably too little in other places, but it shouldn't have me like wildly lean or anything like that. I think it should have me pretty good. That way I can do some kind of initial testing before I go out to the dyno, because we want to make sure everything's good and squared away before we get there. We don't want to get there and like, oh, oops, the clutch is slipping, or it's throwing a weird code, something else is wrong. Make sure everything's happy before then. I got wee whacking and moan going on now. This is what it is. I'll show you how easy this is. We'll pull this out. Diagnostic port, or this cable you get with the power tuner guy. Switch the bike on. You can see fun things like, look, there's full throttle. There's this back. All right, here we go. Flash tune. Yeah, here's some of my other tunes. This is the tune that Ari sent me. This is the tune where Jake took it and threw 10% at it. Let's select that. It's got some notes in here that he's got. 78 millimeter pistons, CBR 300R cams, Yosh exhaust, CBR velocity stack, airbox
boot shortened, we did a similar thing. RPM raised 400. 5% fuel bump to this map. That's me. I did that part. All right. Press the big button to start.
And let it run its course.
Don't touch anything. The first time I ever did this, I accidentally bumped my hand while I was in the middle of this, bumped the ignition and turned it off. Screwed everything up. Luckily, there's like a factory reset thing in here. I was able to like, because this thing was almost bricked. I'm surprised my ECU was okay. Definitely don't do that. Cool, we've done it. All right. An odd situation here. When I tried putting the bike in gear, it died. Not like a normal like kickstand switch hit it, you know, normally that happens, the bike just turns off, but you like the dash and everything stays running. No, like the dash would like flicker out. This computer was like firing on and off. It was acting really funny. I've since tried, I thought, well, maybe I get to something goofy with the map, so I tried Ari's just normal map, same issue. My previous map, same issue. Stock map, same issue. Even tried to do like a recover on the ECU to see if that would fix it. Like something with the ECU. Doesn't matter what I do. Well, first of all, it won't recover. It's saying for some reason that there's an issue and it can't recover the ECU. Slower to questionables or something going on with the ECU. But I've been trying a number of sensors. Like I've got the kickstand sensor down here and some other things. But for whatever reason, I can't seem to figure out what it is. I've talked to Ari. I'm chatting with him and he's told me to try different things. They're all things I've already tried though. I get it. He's like, you think this and that? I'm like, yeah, I thought that. Doesn't seem to be that. But here, I'll try to replicate it for you. All right. No, it's still... I'm going to get it in neutral. It's doing goofy stuff. The fuel pump also will just start going... Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. All right, we're in neutral right now. This thing hasn't even fired on at all. So, put ignition on. I can't fathom what sensor would be causing this unless it just had like a straight short was throwing too much voltage to something, but we should be getting a check engine light. Something else should be happening. The only light we have on right now is ABS, and that's not gonna be causing this issue. That's just because I've deleted the whole ABS system. All right, watch this, we'll fire up. It stalled almost like a kickstand switch, but it's weird because this also just turned off and it shouldn't turn off and it's still off right now. If we wait, yeah, there goes the fuel pump just going like crazy. This is like flickering like it's trying to turn on, so I'm gonna turn that off so I don't damage it. I mean, the only other goofy thing I could say is, man, it almost seems like there's a wiring harness issue, like maybe we creased it somewhere and a bunch of wires are shorted, but I really doubt that. I don't think we ever like hard pinched it, like moving it in and out of things. The fact that it stays running so well in neutral, only has this problem when it goes into gear, it's weird. I've messed with the gear indicating switch, checked out, is there anything goofy with that? Looked at the voltages on there, everything looks normal. When this is happy, this is showing me everything, but whenever you actually are trying to see the problem, if this thing dies, it doesn't have anything in the record. It's bizarre enough, but we have a buddy of ours that lives right around the corner. The other CRF300L guy, as he's known on Discord, those of y'all in the Discord knows he is. He's right around the corner. I asked him, I said, if you're not doing anything, mind coming by, let me borrow your computer real quick, swap it in there, see what it does. Is it that? Is it not that? I don't know. It would be annoying because it's not super cheap for one of those. It's not terribly expensive, but it's like, I wish I could just find like a connector or something that's loose, but the way it's acting is just very odd. So give it a shot and see what happens. It's not the ECU. Sorry, some time has gone by since I've seen you last. ECU came by, stuck it in, same problems persisted. Tried all the things, like everyone I'm talking to, Ari, everyone on the Discord. They're all coming to the great, everyone's thinking right, but there are things I've already tried. We've tried a lot of little things in here. Idle control valve, grounds, faulty grounds all over the place, trying to see if that was a problem. Literally moving and shaking the harness, testing all the individual sensors for the different gears and things. And I'm like, I've got the headlight off right now, but it wasn't that. Like, it was still messing up, but that was off. I don't know. Seems okay right now. I've since then re-added my map, my modified 5% map of Ari's map. It smells kind of rich. Should be a little bit on the rich side. Last time I tested it, I did have the idle control valve thing unplugged. I saw if it made any difference unplugged. It just had a check engine light, didn't get any better. And then when I plugged it back in, I haven't tried it since plugging in. Maybe unplugging it, plugging back in. Maybe it wasn't. Doesn't make me super confident. I don't like issues where something's acting up and there's not a super defined reason for why it's doing it. It seems to be running for now. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna put the whole headlight assembly back on and we'll try it again and see if, like, we'll see. We'll see what it's gonna do. It's fixed itself, I guess. The greatest thing ever. So I can be very, set at ease. Definitely not at all. I'm gonna take it around the block real quick and see if anything pops back up. I got the Discord here with me on the handlebars. Sorry guys, it's about to be, you just want me to mute myself while I'm doing this? So you can still talk to each other? Okay. See, I did a little wheelie there. Totally should be wearing a helmet, but dude, I came up so easy. That tune actually does not seem that off, because that's his tune with just 5% more fuel. You still want to take it off my hands? Well, that seems to be it for this video. Apparently it's working now. Be sure to join my Patreon, because then you can see things like me in the Discord, and you're just here. They got to see the first ride in real time. That was it, so that was kind of fun. If you do join the Patreon, like I said, you gotta link your Discord. And what else, guys? What else do I have to tell them? The next few videos are already on Patreon, aren't they? I keep forgetting to make the last video public. Y'all have had, like, the newest video for over a week, and they haven't even had theirs. I'll do it eventually. Next time, I gotta put the graphics on. You're gonna actually see what this thing looks like. It looks so derp right now without a thing on there. So we'll put all the things on. It'll be gorgeous. I'll get off the bike the wrong way. I love you all. Bye-bye.